What's up, San Diego? John Brooks here, congressional candidate, District 53. It is the last week of January. I've got a lot of things to tell you about, so let's do this. So, on the 25th of January, I was invited to an all-candidates forum. This is significant because it is the first one for the Congressional District 53 that all of the 15 candidates were invited to. Prior to this, many of the groups excluded everyone but four or five leading candidates. And I don't know what that means. I don't know if they're basing on money, name recognition, previous political experience. I don't know, but it's really not fair to those of us who have paid our money to the county, state, and city to be a part of this race, to be able to present our platform to you, the public. And it's definitely not fair to you, the public, the voting public, because you're getting the impression, they're feeding you the impression, that these three, four, five candidates are the only ones in the race here. Even if there's others, you'll see them on the ballot. These are the only ones you should be paying attention to. That is so not right. So, many of these groups, I'm not even going to name them, but many of the groups who held these forums are so-called progressive or liberals and think that they, you know better than the conservatives on the Trump side, and yet they're doing the same thing. I don't think they can see that, but they're being just as exclusive as they claim the Republican Party is. So this was very significant, this last debate, because, well, we weren't given a lot of time because of the amount of people, but that's okay. Right, we had a 2-minute opening speech and then 1 minute to respond to questions that were fed by the audience. It was in Chula Vista, which was great. So I opened up telling them exactly what I just said to you, that I don't think it's fair that only a few people are being offered a seat at the table, if you will, to come to these debates and present their point to the public when there's other candidates out there. So and that went over okay. And then I tried to address most of my questions around the climate crisis. I mean, they asked about gun violence, homelessness, what are you going to do to reach across the aisle, things of that nature. I don't remember all the questions. And I was open and honest about all those questions. But again, I wanted to emphasize, one, we need to fix this global warming crisis, and two, representation. So really, I'll answer your questions, but it's not about what I want to do, because I'm one person. It's about what you, the community, want me to do. It's about us, not me, right? And so I'm promised to be that conduit for you to represent the public. Now, yeah, I have personal views, like on gun violence. I said guns don't stop bullets, which is true. So if you are a gun advocate for the sole reason that you want to protect yourself and your family, you're just gonna have two people throwing bullets, which is, I'm not saying that that's not right. What I'm saying is, do not think just because you have a gun that you will stop violence. And do not think just because you have a gun that a person won't break into your house or try to rob you or whatever the situation is. It won't, unless you're carrying your gun like this, walking down the street like a militia guy. So what we really need to do, and what I emphasize also in my 1 minute rebuttal or speech, was we need to address the root causes of why people want to carry guns. Yes, it is a Second Amendment right, but the Second Amendment, I remind you, was to protect us against governments, not your neighbor. And it also said bear arms, it didn't say handguns, automatic weapons, all this kind of nature, all this things of that nature. And so what I mean by that, you know, why, and I said this, why can't I have a bazooka on my front lawn? Well, that's outrageous. People would not allow me to do that. But that's an arm, right? I'm exercising my Second Amendment right. And you say, yeah, well, John, that's ridiculous. No, they're all weapons of mass destruction, and they all can kill people. So if you're saying, and there are restrictions on bazookas and long-range ballistic missiles and all this other stuff, so why aren't there restrictions on handguns and shotguns and automatic weapons and semi-automatic weapons? So regulation is okay, but again, we need to get the root causes of why we feel we need to arm ourselves, which means society's not safe. I mean, if you're asking me, people don't feel safe in society. How do we fix that, right? You can have 10,000 guns. Someone still may break into your home and try to kill you. So, there was that. There was questions on... one question on the environment. Do you support the Green New Deal? And I said, no, because it doesn't go far enough. The no is sort of a surprise because I'm the environmental candidate. So, yes, I support climate correction. But the Green New Deal is a 10-year plan, and we don't have 10 years. We need to get this in gear in 3 years. Otherwise, the 10-year window is going to just pass us by. We're already in a decline on trying to correct the climate. So to say we have 10 years is kind of optimistic. The ice in the Arctic is melting a lot faster than we had anticipated, which is trapping a lot of methane gas underneath there. And there's more methane gas stored under that ice than there is CO2 in the atmosphere. So it's just going to increase greenhouse gases and increase the rate of climate change a lot quicker than we anticipated. So the estimates right now are that sea levels are going to rise 1 to 4 feet in the next 10 years, maybe 5 years, right? I'm not going to bore you with stats. But anyway, so that went well. And the reason I'm saying that, because this is a week later, I went to another, I was invited to a meeting. It was Safe Access. It's a group that advocates medical marijuana and things of that nature. So I presented myself to them. But when I was in the lobby waiting, I was in the restaurant, some people came up, hey, aren't you John Brooks? Aren't you at that forum? Da, da, da. And I go, yeah. I said, I didn't run you off. I said, no, man, we really like what you had to say. That was like great. And said, you got some supporters here. So that was refreshing to hear. It was really refreshing to hear. One, that they remember my name, they knew who I was, and they remembered I was at the forum, they liked what I had to say. So all that's really refreshing and lets me know that maybe I'm not totally off base with the approach I'm taking on this campaign. No money, representation, fixing the climate. And then I went and talked to the group, and I pretty much said the same thing. I said, look, I'm considering myself a climate candidate. It's the greatest threat facing the nation in modern times. We need to fix it now. I gave my 3-year window, told them why, and my thing about representation. And also, kind of hinting there about the hemp industry. I know they're medical marijuana, but afterwards he told me, yeah, no, we're totally into that hemp too stuff. And what I'm saying by that is hemp, which was once considered the patriotic plant of this country, could do a lot to help correct climate. One, it can capture carbon, it grows fast, it can be a food, it can be a medicinal plant, it could be building material, hempcrete, if you've never heard of that, like concrete, but hemp. Strong, renewable, very durable to replace concrete. Paper-ish, replace the paper. So many different things you can do with it. So I think, and plus it's a renewable crop, so, and good for the soil. So I think we should be looking into that. So that was favorable. There was I also went to the university, San Diego State University, and talked to the Collegiate Black Caucus. I sat in on their meeting, and then I introduced myself at the end of the meeting. They said I can go ahead and crash the party or anything like that. And so what I found interesting, and I told them this, I said, you guys are discussing the same things that came up when I was in college, when I was with the Black Student Union and at the University of Montana. The same issues facing black people are still here today. And that's kind of sad. It's really sad. Nothing has really changed. They're fighting the same fight. So, I really wish that I could go to the college and just mobilize all the students to get behind me on this, because it's going to be their world that we're messing up. It is their world that we're messing up. What else can I tell you? So now there's a couple of forums coming up that I'm going to see if I can get into, and there's a couple I haven't been invited to. We'll see if they invite me. But it'll be interesting. So, until next time, peace out.